Good day everyone. Welcome to lecture number 23 of computer programming. And in this particular lecture, we will be discussing about the arrays. Okay. So before discussing the concept about the arrays, let's define a small scenario. For example, let's say I have 10 employees. Okay. I have 10 employees and I have to store the age of these employees, age in years. Okay, age in years. So how I will store the age of 10 employees? That means I will require 10 variables. Let's say variable 1 is age 1. It will store the age of employee 1. Age 2 is another. Age 3 is the third. Likewise, I will require how many variables? 10 variables. Age 10. Okay. So let's say it is int age 1. This also int age. So all have same data type. So variable age 1, it will store the age of first employee. Age 2, it will store the age of second employee. Likewise, all. Now, instead of 10 employees, let's say I have 100 employees. Okay. Then how many variables will I require to store the age of 100 employees? I will require 100 variables. So I have to declare in my C program how many variables? 100 variables to store the age. Now if I have 1000 or 10,000. So for storing these 100,000 employees, age of these employees, I require these number of variables in my C program. So you can see that means I have to declare these variables, these amount of variables. And this will be a complex task. Because I have to write 100,000 employees. So what C programming has done, or the writers of C program, they have provided a concept of arrays. Using these arrays, we can solve this specific kind of task, or we can simplify this task. What was the task? Task was to store, or we can say to, we require n number of variables, n number of variables of same data type. For example, here it was that we require 100,000 variables. Which variables? Integer variables. And those integer variables I require to save the age of employees. So C programmers, they have provided a simple concept called arrays. The arrays, this concept is used to solve this particular complex task. So what is an array? An array, we can say, is a collection of same type of variables. A collection of same type of variables. What I mean to say, for example, this, let's say, age 100. Int age 100. If I am writing in my C program like this, int age 100, it means that age is an array. So this is the name of an array. And this age has 100 variables. 100 variables. okay, and each variable has data type as int. So how many variables are there? 100. Or we can say this age is like this array, a one dimensional array, or and it has how many variables? 100 variables. That means it can store how many integers? 100 integers. So what is the name of first variable? The name of first variable will be age 0. Name of second variable will be age 1. So this 0, 1, this is called an array index. Array index. And what will be the name of third variable? The name of third variable will be age 2. The name of fourth variable, age 3. And the name of nth variable will be age n minus 1. Okay. So what I am saying, I am here saying that let's say we require 100 variables. 100 variables. Then one way is to declare these 100 variables. Declare 100 variables. Variables of type, let's say int, integer type. Then I have to declare 100 variables. However, arrays have solved, or we can say it has easier, it has made this task easier. What? We have to declare a single array. A single array. And we have to give the size. What should be the size of an array? So by using this scheme, giving a name to an array and providing a size and providing a data type, in a single statement, we can make 100 variables. Likewise, we can make 1000 variables. We can make 10,000 variables. Okay, using an array. So what is an array? An array is a collection of data items, or we can say variables, or we can say variables of same data type. Okay, so let's repeat the same question. For example, if I have 10 employees, now I want to store the age of 10 employees. One method is method one is that I can declare 10 variables, int age 1, age 2, age 3, age 4, age 5, age 6, and age 10. These are my 10 variables. Then I can initialize these. For example, age of first employees is 25. Okay, age of second is 30. Likewise, I have age of other employees. So if we see that in memory, if I have memory, so I am creating these variables, that means in memory there will be some variable age 1. Okay, so it will be stored at this location. The second variable age 2, for example, it will be also stored in memory at some location. Okay, likewise, we have another variable age 3, it will also be stored in memory at some location. Any location, it will be a random location. Okay, let's say address of this is 1000, this is 2000, this is 3000. And likewise, age 4 will also be stored in memory, age 5 likewise. So these will be stored in memory. Okay, so this is method one. The second method is instead of using these 10 variables, since all the variables have same data type int, I can use a simple array. Int, I will declare an array, int age 10. That means I am declaring here, I am declaring 10 variables. 10 variables. So which one is the first variable? The first variable is age 0. The second variable is age 1. The third variable is age 2. Likewise, the 10th variable is age 9. So if I have to give the data, I will give age 0 is equal to, let's say, 24. Age 1 is equal to, let's say, 30. Okay. So that means when I am doing int age 10 in the memory. So likewise, like in previous case, when I am declaring 10 variables as integer. So that means I require how many memory locations? 10 locations. And each location will store an integer. So let's say integer occupies 2 bytes. 2 bytes. So that means, let's say age 1 is stored at 1000. That means this integer will be stored in 2 bytes. 1000 and 1001. Okay. So this age variable will be stored in 2 bytes. So likewise, when I am declaring an array, integer array, that means I require 10 locations in memory to store these 10 variables. Okay. In previous case also, this case also, I require how many variables? I require how many locations? 10 locations. But here you can see that these locations may be distributed randomly in memory. Age 1 may be at 1000, age 2 is at 3000, anyway. However, when I am declaring an array, it also requires 10 locations in memory, but those locations will be contiguous, or we can say continuous. What does that mean? If this array, the first one, this age 0, this is stored at 1000. Let's say integer occupies 2 bytes. Then means age 0 requires how many bytes? 2 bytes. So it will be stored at 1000 and 1001. Then the next one, age 1, it will be stored after that. After this 1001 is 1002. So age 1 will be stored here in memory at 2 bytes. Then age 2 will be stored after age 1. So at 2 bytes. Likewise, other variables. So the difference between this way of declaring a variables, declaring 10 variables, and declaring an integer is that one is here I have to declare all these variables. Okay. Secondly, these variables will be stored in memory randomly. However, in case of integer, I have to directly do this int age 10. That means I require 10 integers. I have 10 integers. And these 10 integers will be stored in memory. But these 10 integers will be stored in continuous memory locations. So A0 will be here, age 1 will be here, age 2 will be here. Continuous to each other. Okay. So what is an array? So here, let's say, what is an array? An array, you can see, an array is a collection of data items, or we can say an array is a collection of similar type of data items, or we can say similar type of variables. So here I have declared which array? Integer array. What is the size? 10 is the size. So this size should be a constant. It cannot be a variable. It cannot be a variable. For example, I can declare a character array. Character name 30. Let's see. It means it is a name array. So it is an array like this. So it has how many locations? It has 30 locations. This is location 0, 1, and the last one is 29. And each location will store a character. So in this array, how many characters we can store? We can store maximum 30 characters. Here it was an array. Which type of array? Integer array. So that means whenever I have to declare an array, how will I declare the array? I will declare an array. First will be a data type. Before that, there will be a storage class. Storage class means whether it is a static, register, global, or automatic. However, if there is no storage class here, then by default, it will be an automatic array. Data type, then name, and then size. As I said, this name can be any valid identifier. And this size should be a constant. It cannot be a variable. If you are using a variable here, it will give an error. Why it will give an error? Because our C program should be informed at the beginning what is the name, what is the size of an array. Because according to the size, it has to allot the memory to the array. Now let's see how we can use an array, okay, in our program, and we will also discuss one or two examples. However, before discussing those examples, let's see how we can initialize array. So how we can initialize array. Okay. So for example, I am declaring here int age 10. That means I have created an array. Which array? Age array. The name is age. Okay. Then it has how many elements? 10 elements. The name of first element is age 0. Or we can say this is our first variable. Okay. First variable. The second variable is our age 1. Then third variable is age 2. And the last variable is age 9. Okay. So if I am doing int age 10, now if I have to give value to the first variable, so I can directly use like this. So this is giving value to an array variable. So it will be an array like this. The size of this array is 10. So the first position will contain 30. Now if I am doing age 3, it will be, let's say, 50. Then that means this is 0, 1, 2, 3. The fourth element, it will contain 50. Okay. For example, if I have another variable A, any variable A, if I give A as age 10, A 0. So it will see what is the value stored here. What is the value stored here? 30. This 30 will be stored in A. So A contains 30. So that means we can access the array elements using the index. And you have to remember, index always starts with 0. Now this is one way of initializing an array, directly giving a value to the variables. The other way is when we are declaring an array, let's see here, we can give here the elements, initialize the array. We can provide, for example, 1, 3, 5, 3, 3, 3, 4, So we can directly initialize an array like this. So this means the first element of an array will get 1. Who is the first element of an array? Age 0. So it will get 1. Then the second element will get 3. Then the third element will get 5. The fourth element will get 3. Likewise others. Okay. So that means you can directly initialize the array like this. However, when you are initializing an array like this, there is no need to write this size. So you can skip this size. It is your choice whether you want to keep it or not. Let's see. For example, if I am doing int age 10 is equal to 2, 3, 4. So here what we are saying, we are creating an array. Which array? Age array. So we are creating an array. So this is our age array. It has how many elements? 10 elements. So 10 elements are there. This is 0th element, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, likewise the last will be 9th. But here we are giving the values. We are given only 3 values, 2, 3 and 4. So the first will get 2, the second will get 3, the third will get 4. So it will get 2, it will get 3, it will get 4. What will be the value stored in the other ones which have not been initialized? So it depends upon the storage class of the array. For example, if the array is an automatic array, then all these empty locations will get garbage value. However, if it is a global array, then these will get 0. Okay. If it is a static array, these will get 0. So it depends upon the storage class what these elements will get. Okay, so now let's say if I am doing like this, int age 2, 3, 4. So let's see the difference. So here also I am creating an array age, but what is the size of this array? The size of this array will be determined by these initial values. So how many values are there? 3 values. So the size of this array will be 3. So it will be only 3. 0, 1, 2. The first will get 2, the second will get 3, and the third will get 4. So the difference between this way and this way is that, initializing this way and this way is that, in this manner, when we are giving the size, it will create an array of that size. And then it will put values, these values there. And the empty values will be given a garbage value or a zero value, depending upon the storage class of this array. However, if I am doing like this, this manner, then in this manner, the size of the array is determined by these values, the number of entries here. So here I have how many entries? 1, 2, 3. So it will create an array of size 3. Okay, so you can use this mechanism and this mechanism. So this mechanism is an storage efficient mechanism. Fine. Now let's see another scenario. For example, int age. Someone is doing like this. Int age is equal to int age 10. Then giving this value. So what does this mean? This means it will create an integer array of how many size? 10 size. Or we can say it will create 10 integer variables. The first one will get 0. The others will get garbage value. Garbage value if the array is automatic. If the array is static or global, then these will get 0. Okay. So that means you can initialize like this, or you can initialize like this or like this. It depends on you. Okay. Now let's see. For example, if somebody did like this. Age 3. int age 3 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. So what it will create an array. So what is the size of an array? The size of an array is 3. That means it will store only 3 elements, 0, 1, 2. Okay. But here we are giving how many elements? 5 elements. So the first location will get 1, second will get 2, third will get 3. The others will also be stored. Okay. Our program won't give any error. It won't give any error, but it may result in some unwanted results. So our program will run. In C, the program will run. In C, you have to remember, C compilers do not check array bounds. What does that mean? C compilers do not check array bounds. That means if we have the size of the array was and we put elements more than 3, then it won't, our compiler won't give any error. Okay. For example, in some other languages, let's say Java. In this language, if you have an array of size 3 and you are putting 4 elements in this array, then it will give an array or it will give an exception. That is called an array out of index exception. But we don't have to discuss it here. You have to remember, C compilers do not check array bounds. So it won't give any error. It will store these variables somewhere. We won't get any error, but it may result in some unwanted results. Our compiler will give a warning. It won't give an error. Okay. So this is about the array initialization, how we can initialize array. The second method, or we can say the second thing that we have to discuss, is how to access the array. Okay. And we know that we can access the array using the name plus index. What does that mean? For example, in this array, if I have to get the third element means at index 2. So I will directly write. So this is how I can access the array. Let's say we have an array int age 3, age 10, let's say. And we want from the user age of 10 employees. So we want to take an input from the user, age of 10 employees, and we want to store these age in this array of 10 employees. How will we do that? Let's see. What we are going to do, we have to take how many inputs? 10 inputs. So we will use scanf. What type of input we want? Percent %d, integer input. And we have to repeat this particular thing how many times? 10 times. Because I have to take age of how many employees? 10 employees. Okay. So I have to repeat this scenario of getting the value from the user. I have to repeat it 10 times. And for repeating it 10 times, I will use loops. So let's say I want to use a loop. In a loop, the index varies from 0 to 9. 0 to 9. And then I will do scanf %d, comma, and age I. So what it is going to do? What is I first? I is initially 0. So it will take this value and it will store this in age I is 0. Then second time I is 1, so it will store the second one at this location, the third one at this location, the fourth one at this location, and so on. So this is how we can get values from the user and store it in an array. So let me write it here. So So for storing values in an array, I can do for int I is equal to 0, I is less than 10, I plus plus, then scanf person D and age I. So you have to remember that we have int age. Okay. So this way I can get 10 values from the user and I will store those 10 values in this array. Now if I have to print, then for printing also I will use for loop. Int I equal to 0, I is less than 10, I plus plus. Okay. Then printf, or since we have already declared I, we will use it here. Printf %d / n age I. So let's see here, user has entered these values 20, 30, 40, 50, 20, 30, 40, 50, 20, 30, 40, 50. So these are 10 values. So these 10 values will be stored in this array, this particular array. Here we are printing it. First we will print the first one. What is first one? 20. Then / n, go to next line. Then it will print 30, then 40, then 50, and likewise. Okay, so that means we can use these loops to take values in the array and to print those values. Now let's write a small program that will use arrays. Okay, so let's write a program. Let's say a C program where user enters 10 numbers. Okay, store those numbers in an array. Then after that, sum all the elements of an array. So let's see how we can write a program for this particular problem. So first we have to do hash include studio.h. Then let's say int main. So I will require an array. What should be the size of an array? 10. So let's say int numbers. Let's say the name of the array is numbers. What is the size? 10. So if I did like this, for example, int n is equal to 10. Then I wrote n here. Int numbers n. What will happen? It will give an error. Why? Because I said that this can be only a constant number. Constant. It cannot be a variable. Here n is a variable. Okay. However, if I wrote constant int n, then I can use n here. Okay. So let's remove it here. So it is 10. Or I can also use, for example, like this. Hash define size as 10. Then I can use int numbers size. So it is a constant here, symbolic constant. So I have declared an array of size 10. The first thing, I have to take 10 numbers from the user and store those numbers in an array. So I will use a for loop. So let's say int I, then for, we will say printf, enter the numbers. Then we have to, user will enter numbers. How many numbers? 10 numbers. So to take input those numbers, we have to use scanf. So we will repeat it 10 times. For I is equal to 0, I is less than 10, I plus plus. Then I will do scanf %d. Then after %d, we have and numbers. I. So up to this point, we will receive 10 numbers from the user and we will store those numbers in this array. So those 10 numbers will be stored in the array. Now I will simply write printf backslash n. This is just to go to the next line. Now the first portion is completed. User enters 10 numbers, store those numbers in an array. This portion is completed. Now we have to sum all the elements of an array. We have to sum these elements. So let's use another variable here. Sum is equal to 0. So I will sum these numbers. So for that I will use for loop again. For I equal to 0, I is less than 10, I plus plus. So what I am going to do, sum is equal to sum plus numbers I. So it will add these numbers one by one. How many times it will add? 10 times. So first it will add number 0, then number 1, number 2, number 3, and the last number 9. The final sum will be stored in this sum. Then I will do printf sum is percent d and then sum, and last I will write return 0. So this is the program. Fine. Now let's say, for example, the same thing we want to repeat. However, here instead of finding the sum, let's say we have to find minimum, or we can say maximum element in the array. So our question is that we have an array. Let's say this is our array, whatever the array is. Okay, let's say it is an integer array. Okay, and in this array we have to find the maximum element, or we can say the maximum value. So not only we require the maximum value, we also require the index at which this maximum value is stored. So let's say this the index starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And the name of this array is numbers. Okay. For example, the maximum value is stored at index 4. Then we need index 4 and this value stored. So how will we do it? What we are going to do, let's say the max, we will keep max as the first element, number 0. So the name is num, let's say. Okay. So we will keep it as a maximum first time. Then we will compare this maximum, okay, with the first element. The first element, we will compare it. Max and num1. Then we will check. So compare means we will do like this. For example, if max is less than num1. Okay. So the maximum element we initially said, let's say this is the maximum element, this one. Now we are saying we are comparing this maximum with the first element. Then we will compare with second, third, and let's see what we are going to do. If max is less than num1, that means this element is less than this element. Okay. If this element is less than the first element, then which one is the maximum? Then this one is maximum. Okay. Then we will say maximum is equal to, and initially let's say index is equal to 0. Then we will say if maximum is less than num1, then our maximum, new maximum will be num1. And new index will be 1. Okay. Else we don't have to do anything. Else our maximum won't change and index won't change. So this we have to do with every element of the array. Which each element, this, and this. And at the end, we will have our maximum value in max and our index in index. Let's write a program to understand it, or let's understand it with the help of an example. Let's say we have 8 stored here, 5, 10, 3, 12, 8, 4, 2. Let's say this is our array. Okay, so which one is maximum? 12 is maximum. So we have to find the maximum element. How will we find the maximum element? Initially, we will have int max is equal to a. Let's say it is num. Int max is equal to num of 0. And int index is equal to 0. Okay. Initially, this we are saying, this is the initial value. So what is in max? In max is equal to 8, because num of 0 is 8 and index is 0. Okay. Now what we are doing, we are saying that we have to repeat this for every element of the array, for every element of array. So what we are going to do, we will run a for loop. For int I is equal to 0. Sorry, int I equal to 1. We won't start from the 0. Why? Because 0 has already been included here. I is equal to 1. I is less than, let's say the size is n. I is less than n. So here size is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I is less than 8. I plus plus. Then in the loop, what we are going to do, we are going to check this condition. If max is less than num of I, then max is equal to num of I and index is equal to I. Okay, let's see whether we will get a maximum number or not. So initially max is equal to 8, index is equal to 0. Now we are in the for loop. So I is starting from 1. Okay, so we are checking here, max is less than num of I. What is I? I is 1, num of 1. So let's check, what is our max? 8. 8 is less than 5. Is it true? Is this condition true? 8 is less than 5? No, the condition is not true. Okay, so it won't execute this portion. So this portion, it won't execute this because the condition is false. Okay, so it will again go here. So our max won't change. Max is 8 and index is 0. Because max and index will only change if we execute this. Second time, now I is equal to 2. So it will compare max with num of 2. What is num of 2? 10. Is max less than num of 2? Yes, because max is 8 and num of 2 is 10. So this condition is true. So we will go here. Now max will become, max is equal to num of 2. What is num of 2? 10. And index will become is equal to I. What is I? I is 2. Okay. Now again we will go into the loop, because the loop has not ended yet. Now I will be 3. Okay. I 3 means this element. 3 is here. Index is here. So is this condition true? Our max is 10. Is 10 less than num of 3? But num of 3 is 3. The condition is false, so it won't execute this. Then the fourth time. Fourth time will be I is 4. Okay. So max is less than num of I. Yes, the condition is true, because max is 10. Okay. So the max is less than num of I. Oh, okay. So this will be executed. Now our max will become 12 and index will become 4. Again, we will run the loop. Now, every time this condition will be false. And at the end, when our loop ends, our max will have 12 and our index will have 4. Okay. So at the end of program, we will get our maximum value. This is our maximum value. And this value is stored at index 4. Okay. So this was a small program depicting how to find a largest number in an array. So your job is to write a program to find a smallest number in an array. So first thing, you have to find the smallest number in an array. The second thing is you have to sort the array. Sort the array. Sort means you can sort it in increasing order or in decreasing order. So if time permits, we will understand this particular question also. We will try to write a program here in this video lecture itself. But if we are not able to do it here, then it is your job to solve this particular problem yourself. So this is how an array is used in our computer programs. Now, since we were mostly discussing about the integer arrays, now let's understand something about the character arrays. Okay, so let's say we have a character array. So let's say we have a character array here. Care, let's say name, and the size is 50. So what does this mean? Here it means that name is a character array. This name is a character array, and it can store total 50 characters. Okay, so it can store how many characters? 50 characters. Fine. Now let's say I can write a character array like this also. Character name 50, and then I can initialize it here using characters. For example, A, then the second will be B, third will be, let's say, small a. Likewise, I can initialize it like this. Or I can also initialize character array like this. Name 50 is equal to, then I will store, let's say, any value, computer program. Okay. This way also we can store our characters in this character array. So here it is a character array. This is an array. The first element, the first thing that is stored in this will be A, then B, then A, and likewise. Okay, fine. Now, if I am writing like this, it will be same. So, it is my character array. Okay, first C will be stored, then O, then M, likewise. But the difference between this one and this one, that at the end there will be \0. \0 means end of string. This is also a character. \0 is a character. This is \0. So why we require this \0? We have already discussed this \0. It is required, for example, if I want to print this string. So for printing, I will write printf. Then directly I will do %s, then name. Okay. Name means that print this string. Basically what it is going. So we know. So to understand this, you have to understand that the name of an array, for example, if I have an array int age 10. So we already discussed that when we are declaring int age 10, it means that in memory we are creating 10 memory locations. So we will have 10 memory locations. Here we will store age 0, then we will store age 1, then we will store age 2. So let's say the address of this location is 1000. The address of next location will be 1002. Why 1002? Because one integer occupies, let's say it occupies 2 bytes. So that means it will be stored in two addresses, 1000 and 1001. So the next age 1 will be at 1002. Then another one will be at 1004. Okay, likewise. This age, if I directly write age in the program, this is basically a pointer. Pointer means that this variable will store the address of first element. Address of first element. Okay, what is the address of first element? 1000. So age will be storing 1000. Okay, so you have to remember the name of an address, the name of an array is basically a pointer to an array, or we can say it is the address of first element. So which one is the first element? Age of 0. So the address of this age of 0, I am saying the address of this will be stored in this variable age. But we know that address of age of 0 can also be written like this, and, because ampersand is 0 means address at which age 0 is stored. And here I am also saying that whenever we are declaring an array, then the name of an array, this name here, the name of an array is pointer to the first element, or we can say it is an address of the first element. So that means age and age, they are one and the same thing. Okay, so now when I am doing here printf%s, printf the string, which string? So basically it will go to this address, and from this address it will take a string and it will print that string here. So here I am saying that name is, this is computer programming. So that means in memory, I will have different locations. So here like this. And in these locations, I will have stored computer programming. Okay. Now I am saying printf%s name. So that means go to this address, first address, and then print the string. But for printing the string, it should know up to which point I have to go. Or we can say it should know the end of string. Because otherwise it will print everything in the memory. So it should know the end of string. So for knowing the end of string, we will have \0 at the end. That means there will be at the end \0. So it will check that \0 and it will print only up to that point. That is why there is need of \0 at the end of a string. Otherwise, the other way of printing a string is that you have to check each time whether there is end of string. End of string means \0. Whenever there is end of string, so we will stop there. So our printf automatically checks, internally it checks the end of string, but we can do it manually also, writing a program that checks the end of the string. We can do that as well. For example, if I have a program like this, so let's see, if I have a character array, okay, this is my character array name, and in this character array, for example, I am writing a character A, B, P, L, E, then I have this \0, then I have, let's say, X, Y, whatever I have, okay? Then if I do printf, %s, okay, and then name, what will it print? It will only print to the point where we have \0. So it will only print Apple. It won't print the other things, because whenever it finds \0, it automatically assumes that it is the end of the string. Or otherwise we can do like this. For example, while let's say we have int I, let's say int I is equal to 0, while, and we have char c, while c is equal to name I, while c is not equal to backslash 0, okay, we will go on printf percent c c. So what it is going to do, and also sorry, then internally we have I plus plus. So this is our loop. What is this particular thing going to do? So initially I is 0. Now c is equal to name of I. So I is 0, name of 0. So c will be a, this character a. Now it is checking is not equal to backslash 0. So up to the point when we reach to this backslash 0, we will go into this particular loop. Okay, so it is going to print first app a, then I will be incremented. Now I will be 1, so it will c will be our p, so it will print p, then l, then e. Then our condition, when it reaches here backslash 0, this condition will become false, so it will go outside the loop, so it will print apple. So this loop is going to print apple. So what I am trying to make you understand here, that we can use a character array, and that array can be used to store a string. You can print that string character by character using a while loop like this, or you can directly print like printf percent s then name of the array. So this print internally, or we can say automatically, checks for backslash 0, and this loop, we here wrote a condition that checks the backslash 0. So you can use this approach to print a string, or you can use this approach to print a string. So it is your choice which approach you want to use. Okay. So this is how a character array is used in our C programs. So character array is used to store a string. Okay, and every string ends with backslash 0. Why there is a need of backslash 0? Because when we are printing a string, we should know the end of the string. Fine. So this completes the discussion about the character arrays. Now, as I said, that our character array is a string. Okay. Our character array is a string. So in our C programming language, there is already a library called string.h that has some well-defined functions, that has some functions that can be used to, that those functions can be used to perform some specific operations on strings. For example, one function is strlen, string length. So this takes input here, this takes the argument name of character array, and it returns the length of the character array. So what I am going to say here, for example, I have character name, let's say this is my array, let's say we have stored something here, computer programming. Okay, now if I am doing int l, then I will do l is equal to string length. So but I have to include hash include string.h, this library, because this library contains some functions. Those functions can be used to modify or do some operations with the strings. So string length, what it is going to do, it will take this string. Basically, it will take the string stored at this address, because this is a pointer. This is basically an address. The name of an array is the address of first location. So string length function goes to this location in memory and it finds the string stored at that location and it returns the length of that string. So what is the length of this string, this particular string that it is going to return? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and space 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20 including backslash 0, because at the end we will have backslash 0. We are not writing it here. It internally puts backslash 0 at the end. So that will be 21. So it will return 21. So in L we will have 21. So the length of string is 20. So basically not 21, it will return 20. So it won't include this backslash 0 at the end. So the length will be 20. For example, if I do L is equal to string length, then inside I have a string. Let's say ABC. So what is the length of the string? 1, 2, 3. So in L we will have 3. So here the argument of this function, this particular function, it can be a string or a character array. And it will return the length of the character array. Okay, so this is an inbuilt function and this function has been described in string.h. Now you, without using string length, you can also find the length of a string. How will you find the length of a string? For example, this is our string computer program. How will you find the length of the string? So we won't use this particular function. How will we find out? For example, what we are going to do, we will do int I is equal to 0, then char c, let's say c, char c, and after that we will run a while loop. While c is equal to name i is not equal to 0, then we simply have to do i plus plus, and then we will do printf length of string is %d, i plus 1. So let's say this is my string. In name, we have stored a, b, c. So basically in memory, it will be like this. We will have first a, then b, then c, then backslash 0. Let's see what this program is going to do. Initially, I is 0, so C is equal to, C will be name of 0. What is name of 0? Name of 0 is A. So C is A. So we are saying while is not equal to backslash 0. So this condition is true because A is not equal to backslash 0. So it will go inside the loop. Now inside the loop, we have I plus plus. So I will become 1. Now it will again go here because the condition is true. Now again, C is equal to name of 1. What is name of 1? B. So the condition will be true because B is not equal to backslash 0. So it will go here. I will be 2. Then again, it will go here. Check C is equal to name of I. So sorry, here it will print. C is equal to name of I. Name of I is 2. So here C. So it will have C. So condition is true because C is not equal to backslash 0. So it will go inside the loop. Inside the loop, we have I plus plus. Now I will become 3. So now it will check, C will get name of 3. Name of 3 is backslash 0. So C is backslash 0. So is backslash not equal to backslash 0? No, it is equal to backslash 0. So the condition is false. So it will come outside the loop. And outside the loop, it will print f, length of string is %d, i. So what is i? I is 3. So it will print length of string is 3. So without using string length, we can find the length of a string. However, these functions are already there in the string.h library, so we don't have to write this particular program. We can directly use these particular functions. So there are many other string functions. For example, we have string copy, we have string string, we have string compare. So there are many other string functions that are already defined in string.h. So I will stop this particular lecture here, and in the next lecture we will start discussing about these different functions that are used to modify the strings, and also we will discuss about the multidimensional arrays in C programming language. So let's meet in the next lecture. Till then, goodbye.